In a country which is largely governed by the celebrity party, I am the voice of opposition.
Excuse me, can I have a quick word?
Yes.
How are you?
Hello, who are you?
I'm Dennis from BBC Two. How are you?
Hello.
You busy?
Very.
Yeah?
In fact, the man I'm working for has just disappeared, Stuart Purvis of ITN. Yes.
I read somewhere you don't like to be recognised. Is that correct?
I think that's pretty correct.
Yeah, that's fair enough. Who the hell are you anyway?
Well, I don't know. Who are you? From BBC Two.
I am. Nothing. You're not in LA now, but you spent a lot of time in LA.
I have, yeah. I just spent 5 weeks there.
I always think of LA as sort of muesli, if you know what I mean. Take away the nuts and the fruit, and it's all flakes. How do you like your cereal? You like your cereals sort of crunchy or mushy? Mush.
Well, I only had about 2 seconds to think when I was in LA, so I didn't have much time to think about my cereal. But you're right. It's insane, though.
No, come in here.
It's the winner.
Michael, I understand you have 9 toilets. Is that right? You have 9 toilets?
Yeah, I have 9 toilets, but I didn't bring any of them with me.
So you actually make a lot more crap than people give you credit for, right?
No question of it.
Hi, Keith. Hi.
Oh, off.
How are you?
Hi. What's this show?
This is BBC Two. It's the Sunday show.
Sunday show, right.
Now, I have to tell you, Hugh, I must be honest with you, I find your acting a little bit woody. A little bit woody.
Woody, right? Yes.
I mean, when you made your appearance in the film Sirens, I thought someone threw a chair into the room.
Uh-huh.
How do you get yourself psyched up? I mean, you go into the forest and sort of stare at a few trees or...
Oh, you can off.
Oh, yeah.
If heavy smoker Mariella Fostrop were a dog, she'd definitely be a husky. Because not only has she got the voice for it, but they also come in packs of 20.
Can I have a couple of short questions? I've just been up to the party. Everybody out there is wearing Chanel number 5.
Really? Are you sure?
Yeah, you seem to be wearing Embassy number 6. Was that a conscious decision?
You obviously haven't got a nose for perfume.
No, I'm right. This tea is great, man. Yeah, it's nice. Lovely. Have a nice day.
There's no way I could buy you. Are you for sale? Could I buy you?
No, why?
Well, because I collect old comics, you see.
Oh, that's right. I'm the Beano of all time.
Can I maybe sew up a deal with you after the...
Okay. You were talking high finance here. 85 pence at least, I would have thought.
It's a deal.
Okay, you're on.
Beautiful.
Cheers.
Pleasure to have you in my collection.
Thank you.
See ya.
All the best.
Hi, Clive.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. How are you?
Very well, thank you.
Right.
I just wanted to know, as a legal man...
Yes?
Do you worry you ever might sort of lose your appeal?
You're writing your own script, or are you getting them off?
No.
Off mugs, or
it's
something.
It's all mine, baby.
Yes,
it's all mine.
Well, I think I lost my appeal a long time ago.
You did?
Yes, absolutely. Yes.
That's unfortunate. Well, what's confusing, I find, is that as a lawyer, you're very expensive, but on the television, you're very cheap.
Yeah, cheap. You think I'm cheap?
I think you're fairly cheap.
I'm cheap on your program because you just come up and incorporated me.
That was quite cheap, wasn't it?
This is like through the
through the station. Finally,
through the keyhole without the budget. This isn't it.
We've got a big budget.
Have you?
Right. Well, I want to finally. Yeah. You got any plans of making a program about classical music? Sort of Clive Anderson talks Bach?
No. But, that's a very. I must write these down.
I
got my Bach.
Right. Just thirsty.
Yeah. And who do you work for?
Very nice. Whose wine is it anyway?
You
got
a prop and a joke?
Keep the rest. I've got to get a train.
I'm in Cannes for the 50th anniversary of the film festival.
Ken, I imagine you're not that popular at picnics, man. You always take the biggest roles for yourself. Miss Passenger, do you think it was ironic you did boxing a laner and ended up losing an arm or a leg? Ken, you look like a blonde bombsite. Dustin, did you see the Bruno Tyson fight?
Yes, I did.
You reminded me so much of Bruno that night.
Why?
Because neither of you could come up with a hook that people wanted to see.
I didn't get it.
You know, a lot of the people in Cannes start at the bottom and lick it. You know, of course, Cannes also attracts stars from the pop world. And they don't come much bigger than Elton John. At 3, he plays the piano. At 4, he writes lyrics. By 5:30, he's got another crap song. Elton. Elton, BBC. Elton. Do you know what they call you in Germany? Elton, you know what they call you in Germany, man? Hairpiece. Now, think about this town is everybody wants to get noticed. People spend millions and millions of francs just to get a bit of attention, you know? And I'm going to show you a way of doing it for nothing. Watch this.
Can I have a quick word for the BBC?
You know what? I can't write it.
You came with a lot of criticism with striptease. How do you handle your knockers?
You know what, hon? I'm not here to talk about myself, okay. All right?
Can I just say, did you know that Errol Flynn passed away with a huge erection? Do you think your husband will die hard, too? Okay, have fun. Excuse me. Do you collect furniture?
Pardon me?
Do you collect furniture?
No.
Oh, I was going to ask if I could... I got a great sofa at home, swap your old rocker.
A sofa?
The secret of great acting is sincerity. Once you learn how to fake that, you're laughing. I've constructed a brief public information film for your benefit. Now, in an earthquake, plates move against one another, causing a... fault! Producing... massive shakes, striking fire into the hearts of the public at large. Yeah, but this is Hollywood. The show must go on.
Hey, could you do me a really big favor? Tap me on the shoulder and say, Dennis, can I speak to you?
Okay. Dennis, can I speak to you?
Yeah, 1 minute. I'm still in Hollywood, and I'm going to be...
Hello, BBC.
Hello there.
Hello there. How are you?
Nice to see you.
How you doing?
Very
good.
Terrific.
And you? Great. Oh, excuse me. Ooh, we're off and running. Oh, sorry.
And also in the advent of having sort of oral sex, do you sort of... Well, when you're participating in oral sex, do you suffer from the Velcro effect?
I don't know. That's private.
Yeah, that's a good answer. So you excited about tonight?
I am very excited.
You put on the English accent, I'll put on the American one.
All right, right. And you'll be... It's Michael Caine. This is my wife, Shakira.
You're only supposed to blow the bloody doors. How did you handle the sex scenes? Were they very pressurized? I mean, you're a sex bomb, but rumors are that you got quite a short fuse.
I have a short fuse.
Apparently.
No? That's not what I've been told. You've been
not
hearing
true.
Bad rumors. No, my fuse is, you know,
it's
healthy.
It's a sizable fuse.
It all works.
Desmond, I understand you got mugged earlier.
What?
I understand you got mugged earlier.
Oh, yes.
I heard somebody got arrested for jumping the queue.
Yeah.
What a life you got. I mean, the press, the cameras, the journalists, I mean, don't they get pissed off with you following them around everywhere?
Totally pissed.
I gotta tell you, I saw Golden Eye, I was glued to my seat.
All right.
Otherwise, I'd have left. Sure, I got nothing better than that.
You happy with this part?
This part, I like to play the guy in the very comfortable pants. I'm switching accents
nice
on you now, I'm sorry.
You're confusing me.
Yeah.
But I understand once you actually got turned down for the part of a wolf on account of being too hairy?
No, actually, I was offered the part in Congo and Gorillas in the Mist. See, these are never wear Quest for Fire opera gloves.
But also, I want to know, are you ever going to release an autobiography?
On what?
Well, on your life. I mean, everyone wants to read about it. Would you ever consider doing that?
Do you want to read about it?
I want to read about it.
Really?
Why not? You know, because if it's about you, presumably the book wouldn't have a title.
That's a good one.
Amazing.
I've actually had people throw red paint on me and people go,
don't wear fur! Is it correct that recently you've been writing sheets and sheets of music and then erasing them and rubbing them out?
No.
Oh, because if you don't mind me saying, I heard that you were decomposing these days. Is that correct? No. Wrong? Right? Wrong? Wrong. Wrong.
Thank you.
Pleasure. Bob, can I have a quick chat with you, ma'am?
Sorry.
I understand that the British Telecom has had a very, very powerful effect on movie producers and directors.
Is it?
Well, I hear every time you go for a job, they say, don't call us, we'll call you. So you must be very pleased that it's
so
really... Kevin! Hi, man. Morning. Listen, I've come a long way to see you. Listen, in Waterworld, you play some kind of fish. Don't you think it was inevitable you get battered by the
enough
critics?
Enough of this shit with you and the fish.
Hey, I like fish, man.
Go away.
Kevin, can I just shake your hand, man? Whoa, what are you kidding about? Kevin! Hi, man. Hey, I love you. Listen, you know, in your film, you drank your own urine. I like a guy who takes the piss out of himself and then puts it back in, you know?
Yeah.
Kevin. Can you just write a few words for me, please? Just write a few words for me, please.
You are a dick.
I love you. You've invented a new genre, you know. I've seen a lot of B movies, but you made a C movie. In both senses of the word.
That's why you're a lumberjack.
Sure, I'm
here. You're intelligent.
I'm proud of it, you know.
Being called a low-budget guy by Kevin Costner is actually quite a compliment. In his world, that's about $150 billion. In the movie, you play a guy with long hair, so Neanderthal barbarian.
Yeah.
Being an Australian, you worried that might get you typecast? I gotta thank you, though, because I haven't had sex in a long time. I went to see the movie and slept with the entire audience. So,
great. Thank you.
Thanks for everything, man.
That's the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard.
Hi, guys. Baz, Babbing Boy from the Mail. How are you? Maxi, Paparami. That's the air. You want this? Can I join you guys?
You can, yeah.
Sure,
yeah.
But you know, I'm like, people.
Okay, I'll see you around, yeah? Tom? Tom? You made the ultimate space movie. completely lacking in atmosphere, you know?
Now, one of the biggest cliches about being in New York is that the whole experience is like being on a film set. Wherever you are in this town, whatever you're doing, you feel like you're in a movie.
I was wondering if you'd like to go out for a kebab with me sometime.
No.
Do you practice safe sex? Out of interest? Sorry, I heard you haven't been to bed with a Johnny for a couple of years.
I wasn't talking about Polly, I was taking the piss out of you.
I was taking the piss out of you.
Hi, Bob.
Dennis!
Hi, man.
Dennis!
Hey.
Dennis,
hey,
oh, Dennis. God, God bless. Dennis!
Jeremy, can you do me a huge favor?
What's that?
You get out of my way, man. Thanks. Jeffrey, can I just say, over the years, you've been accused of speaking quite a lot of crap. I just wonder if you had any comment.
Hi. Has anyone ever told you you're really beautiful and meant it?
No. I'm sure.
Right, man. Right on. Okay. Let's go.
Hey, what's going on, Paul?
Hey, he's right. Let's get a taxi.
Oh, I hate this place. Funny thing is, as a kid, I really hated Leicester Square. Whenever I came down here with my parents, I used to just hate the whole atmosphere here. And typically, Sod's Law come up with a character, which means I got to basically move in here for 2 years. So, this was my workplace. It was the Odeon. It's where I got Clint Eastwood, I think. Waited 30 years to meet him and ended up pointing an ice cream at him. 49p Magnum.
You feel licky, punk?
And I remember standing there and there was, got this veiled compliment from a bouncer who said, "All right, Dennis, loved your video, but you step over that barrier, I'm going to take you around the back and kick your fucking head in." That was nice. Another video sale. And what was my routine? I remember used to come out of Leicester Square Tube, stick the glasses on, go up to the dive bar, have 5 double Jack Daniels, line of speed, and go to work. What a pro. I think the last ever Pennis interview was just around about here. I can't remember what the premiere was, but I remember being in a really bad mood and it was raining and I couldn't be arsed, and then Simon Le Bon showed up and I chased him down the road, didn't really have anything to say, and he grabbed my glasses off me and took my mic off me, and I just ended up calling him a wanker. You know, why be clever when you can just be accurate? Russell Grant, never liked him, and round about there I got him, and I went up to him and said, "Hey Russell, can you read palms?" And he said, "Of course I can." So I said, "What does that say?" And I had, "Fuck off, you fat cunt," right on my hand. We still speak.